Hello students, myself Jyoti Rajdan. We all have done yesterday the matrices, different types of matrices, equality of matrices. Now today we will do some operations on matrices. Operation on matrices, the first operation is addition of matrices. Addition of matrices, what we do, we take two matrices A and B. What we have to do, if A is a matrix having the elements x, y, z, w and B is a matrix having the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? Now, what is done in addition? We add the corresponding elements of matrix A with matrix B. Now, if I start adding, so I have to, this is the A11 element of A and this is the A11 element of B. I have to add x with 1, y with 2. Now, that means, now there is no element here with which I can add this 3. So, what that means, something is missing. So, what is important in addition of the matrices is the two matrices. So, we should have one element here also. That means the order of A and B should be same. That means if A is a matrix of order 2 by 2, B should be also the matrix of same order 2 by 2. So, this is the important point. We can add the two matrices only if they have same order. That is the important point. So, you have seen why is it important to have the order same. So, now you can easily add up the elements of A with elements of B. So, what will be the resulting matrix? A plus B. A plus B will be x plus 1. Then y plus 2, z plus 4 and w plus 5. Okay. Now, you can take another example. I can replace this matrix by numbers 4, 3, 5, 6. So, what will be A plus B? A plus B will be 4 plus 1, 5, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 4, 9, 6 plus 5, 11. And now, you can see the A and B are the matrices of same order. And what is the order of the resulting matrix? Order of the resulting matrix is also 2 by 2. That means if A is a matrix of order m into n, B is a matrix of order, B will be also a matrix of order m into n, and A plus B will be also the order m into n. Clear? Torvavain toi fikri ki kitkanch az matrices add karan. Next is, after addition of the matrices, next is multiplication. Multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. Scalar is a constant. That means, if you have a matrix A as 1, 2, 3, 4 and you want to have a matrix 3A, what are you doing? You are multiplying matrix A by a scalar. Scalar is a constant. This can have any value. So, right now I have given the value to this scalar as 3. So, 3A will be, that means you are multiplying every element of the matrix by 3. So what will be the resulting matrix? Resulting matrix will be 3 into 1, 3 into 2, 6, 3 into 3, 9, and 3 into 4, 12. Okay, so this is multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. Now, if you have done multiplication, now similarly, you can take common from the matrix also. If you see that the all the elements are the multiples of 3, you can take out 3 common and you can write it as 3a by taking common. That means if you are multiplying by a scalar multiplication, then next is its division. That means if you can multiply by a scalar, you can also divide by a scalar, provided only condition is that scalar should not be equal to 0. So this is multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. Torvutai fikri ye. Now, if I am saying multiplication of a matrix by a scalar, the scalar is minus 1 also. I can multiply it by minus 1. What will I get if I am finding minus 3a? Minus a, so what will be it? This element, if you are multiplying 1 by minus 1, it will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and minus 4. That means if A is any matrix, you can have minus A also. So this is A and this is minus A. Now I can add these two matrices. If I add the two matrices, I will get A plus minus A. If I add the two matrices, what will I get? 1, I will add 1 with the corresponding element. 1 minus 1 will be 0, 2 minus 2 will be 0, 3 minus 3, 0, 4 minus 4, 0. That means if you are getting A plus A, A plus minus A will be 0, 0, 0. So what is this? This is a 0 matrix. And that means if I write this matrix as B, so what will you get? A plus B equal to 0. If you get sum of the two matrices as 0, then this B is called the additive inverse. So how to check whether the given matrix is the additive inverse of the given matrix or not? What will you do? You will add up the two matrices A and B. If A plus B is equal to 0, then B is the additive inverse of A and A is the additive inverse of B. Is it clear to all of you? So now we have learned this additive inverse also. And 0 is called the additive identity. Toru vantoy fikri. Additive inverse kya ga? Now using these operations, let's solve one question. If you are given A equals to 2, 6, minus 1 and 0, B is 2, and you have to find A minus 3b. A minus 3b. So what will I do? A is there. I need 3b. So I will first of all find 3b matrix. So that will be 3b will be. That means you are multiplying every element of B by 3. So what will be the resulting matrix? It will be 3 into 3, 9, 3 into 5, 15, 3 into 2, 6, and 3 into 4, 12. And now I have to find A minus 3B. So A will be 3B will be this matrix. Clear? Now you will find the difference of the two matrices. That is, 2 minus 9 will be minus 7. 6 minus 15 will be minus 9. Minus 1 minus 6 will be minus 7. Then 0 minus 12 will be minus 12. So, this is the value of A minus 3B. And you can see the order is same. Order of A is 2 by 2, order of B is 2 by 2, and the order of the resulting matrix is also 2 by 2. This is how we multiply matrices by scalar, and you can add the two matrices. Now, this is one of the important properties of addition is commutative property of addition. We will check whether the matrix addition is commutative or not. I think all of you know what is the commutative property of addition. The commutative property of addition is if A plus B is equal to B plus A. This property we have to check whether it satisfies. It satisfies for the numbers, for real numbers, for rational numbers, irrational. You have already done in your previous classes. So now we will see whether it satisfies for the matrices also or not. So I will take two matrices A and B. This is A and this is B. So all of you know how to add the two matrices. So, I will add the two matrices, 2 plus 5, 7, 3 plus 6, 9, 4 plus 2, 6, 5 plus 0, 0. So, this is A plus B. Now, next is I will find B plus A. So, this is B and this is A. B plus A will be 5 plus 2, 7, 6 plus 3, 9, 2 plus 4, 6, and 0 plus 5, 5. I have written wrong here. 5 plus 0 is 5. So now you can check, is A plus B equal to B plus A? You can check every element, 7, 7, 9, 9, 6, 6, 5, and 5. So, you can see A plus B equals to B plus A. That means commutative property holds. So, the matrix addition, or you can say matrix addition is commutative. So, if you have A plus B, the B plus A will be same as A plus B. This is the commutative property of addition. So, similarly, you have the next property as associative property. You will see that associative property also holds. That means A plus B plus C is same as A plus B plus C. So, what is the requirement for the three matrices? The first thing is the matrices A, B and C should be of same order. Then, only the bracket changes. A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C. Here, in the left side, you will add B and C matrices first, and in the right side, you will add these two matrices first. You can take example also for three matrices. A, B and C are the three matrices. Now let's check whether this property holds or not. So here for the left hand side I need to find B plus C first. I will write it A plus, now A is a matrix, Now I adding B and C. Now if I add B and C, what is 6 minus 2? 4, 5, I am adding the 2. 5 plus 1, 6, this is minus 3, minus 3 plus 3, 0, 0 plus 5, 5. Now this is the, this is A, this is B plus C. Now I will add these two. What will I get? 1 plus 4, 5, 2 plus 6, 8, 3 plus 0, 3, and 4 plus 5, 9. So this is my left hand side, A plus B plus C. Now I will proceed to find this one. I will find A plus B first and then I will add up with C. A plus B, 1 plus 6, 7, 2 plus 5, 7, 3 minus 3, 0, and 4 plus 0, 4. And the elements of C I will write here. So 7 minus 2, 5, 7 plus 1, 8, 0 plus 3, 3, and 4 plus 5, 9. You can see what is the matrix here, and let's compare the elements of both the sides. 5, 5, 8, 8, 3, 3, 9, 9. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. It means the associative property also holds in matrix addition. Torvatoivan Fikri, properties of matrix addition. Timchi commutative asan, which is associative the asan. After addition, the next operation on matrices is multiplication. Multiplication of matrices. Now, for making you understand the multiplication of matrices, let me give you an example. Suppose two friends, Ram and Shyam, go to the market. To buy something to eat. You know the favorite things you want to eat is chocolates and chips. And Ram buys 4 chocolates. So they buy chocolates and chips. Suppose Ram buys 4 chocolates and 3 packets of chips, and Shyam buys, he thinks if he has bought 4, I'll buy 5. 5 and he'll buy 4 packet of chips. Now, this is the quantity they need. Now, they will ask the shopkeeper, what is the price for the chocolate and for the chips? So, what they'll ask, and he'll say 50 rupees for chocolate. One chocolate is for 50 rupees and 20 rupees is the price of chips. So now they will calculate how much they have to spend. So I will represent this information in the form of matrix. Okay. So now all of you know, how will you calculate how much money Ram has to spend? So he has bought 4 chocolates. So what will he do? He will multiply 4 with 50. So that means he has spent 200 for, he'll buy, he'll do this 4 into 50. And what else he had taken? He has taken 3 packets of chip, and the cost of each packet is 20 rupees. So he'll do 3 into 20. Okay. Now the second one, the Shyam will also calculate. How will he calculate? 5 into 50. plus 4 into 20. That's what, that's how you calculate the price. So this is for Ram and this is for Shyam. So what amount they have spent? 200 plus 60 and 250 plus 80, which is equal to 260 plus 330. That is the amount they have spent. That means Ram has spent 260 rupees and Shyam has spent 330 rupees. Is it clear? That's how you calculate the price. Now let me correlate it with matrices. What you have done, if you take this as row, this is row 1 and this is row 2. This is C column 1 and this is column 2. And this matrix is having 2 rows and 1 column. So what is the order of this matrix? Order of this matrix is 2 by 2. And what is the order of this matrix? Order of this matrix is 2 by 1. That means if you want to, you have multiplied. If you want to multiply the two matrices, what is the requirement? The number of columns. How many columns are here? 2 columns. And how many rows are here? 2 rows. Number of columns in matrix A should be same as number of rows in matrix B. And that means these two should be same. And what will be the order of the resulting matrix? The order of the resulting matrix will be 2 by 1. Let's check. Are you getting the order 2 by 1? Clear. This matrix is having order 2 and 1. So now how we multiply the matrices? What you have done, you have taken the first row and the first column. You have taken, that means you have multiplied the elements of first row with the elements of the column. 4 with 50, 3 with 20. That means the first thing you will do, you will multiply. So what will be the element? This will be C1 and this will be R1. So this means this element is multiplied by this and this element is multiplied by this. The elements of row are multiplied with the elements in the column. So this is how we multiply. You can see 4 into 50 plus 3 into 20. Then you will take up the second row, 5 into 50 plus 4 into 20. This is matrix multiplication. This is how we multiply the two matrices to find the total amount. We can express our income and expenditure also in the term of matrices, and we can find the profit gained by the matrix, gained by us. That means if I have a matrix A of order m into n, the product will be defined only if B is a matrix of order n into p, because you know the order is row into column. I told you the number of columns here should be same as number of rows. There were 2 columns and 2 rows. That is why the product was defined. So if A is a matrix of order m into n, B is a matrix of order n into p, then only the product is defined. These two should be same. And AB, the product AB will be of the order m into p. This is very important. So that means if A is a matrix of order 2 by 3, B is a is also a matrix of order 2 by 3. Can we multiply the two matrices? No, We cannot multiply the two matrices because 3 is not equal to 2. Like, so that means this is an important point which you should note, that you can add the matrices of the same order, but it is not necessary that you can multiply the matrices of same order, because for the multiplication the requirement is the number of here, number of columns here should be same as number of rows here. So in order the product to be defined, the B has to be a matrix of order 3 should be here, and here you can have any number, it can be 3 by 3 also. Only thing, important thing is this should be same. So for you cannot add the, it is not necessary that you can add the matrices of same order. You can add the matrices of same order, but not necessary you can multiply them. Now let's do the, now you have one multiplication of the matrices. Now because this was a simple matrix, which type of matrix it was, we have done yesterday, it is having only one column, so it is a column matrix. Now we will take different types of matrices, so we can practice for the product of, you can take two matrices A and B and you can multiply them, but before multiplying the two matrices you have to check the number of columns in A should be same as number of rows in B. Torvatai fikri ki kitkanche as hakan the matrix panway multiply karethan.
घर बैठे पाएं राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत। NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी। शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश लेने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें, अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं, क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रीयकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति, जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।